Our application has now been deployed, or at least the front end has. Let's see how we can set up that back end database. I'm going to go back into Azure and I'm going to click home here and I'm going to hit create a new resource and I'm going to choose Cosmos DB. So Cosmos DB is a neat little document database that has a few different APIs that we can use and a serverless tier, so that way we only pay based on consumption. I'm going to click create and I'm going to put this into that resource group that I set up earlier, which is that tasks demo. On the account name, I'm going to call this tasks demo. Give that just a second to validate. There we go. On the API, we want MongoDB API. So that MongoDB API, you can actually just use the MongoDB API if you wanted to, or in our case, we can use Mongoose, and that's what we'll be doing. We'll put this into West US2. One big thing when it comes to performance in Azure is making sure that all of your resources are in the same location, in the same region. So we'll put that into West US2. I'm going to scroll down here and choose serverless and then click review and create and then click create. And we'll give this just a couple of moments to create. This might take it a minute or two, but again, because of the fact that you're watching the video, you'll notice that it will complete about now. With our database created, now let's go in and configure our application to use it. I'll need to go grab the connection string, which I can do by clicking Go to Resource, going to Quick Start here, and then clicking Node.js because that's what we're using, and then grabbing this connection string right here. So I'm going to click Copy here. That will copy that to the clipboard. And now let me update my application. So I'm going to do this on Azure. So let me open up that Tasks Demo static web app. Let me click on configuration here. And I'm going to add in a brand new configuration setting called connection string and then paste in that value here. Let me hit okay and let me hit save. What that did is it created a brand new environmental variable called connection string. If I go back and take a look at my code here real quick, what you'll notice is if I scroll back up inside of my Azure function, that's what we're looking for here, is that connection string. So process.env.connectionString, that's how we're grabbing the connection string. And that is the value. Let's open up the right window. There we go. That's the value that we created. So connection string, and there's the value. So now let's go back to our application. Let me hit refresh here. Give this a moment. Now, nothing will happen because we don't have any tasks yet inside of our database. So let me create a brand new task, maybe like record videos, since that's what I'm doing right now. I'm going to click add task. And then now that appears on the screen. I'm going to go ahead and put the little check there. That's going to cross that out. And if I refresh the page here just to prove that it is saving behind the scenes, you'll notice that that's now checked out. I could go ahead and uncheck that. Again, hit refresh just to prove that it's coming from the database. There it is. And away we go from there. So over those three videos, what we saw was how we could create a project that's going to use Vanilla.js and Mongoose to create an application that uses a MongoDB API-driven database. We saw how we could use that template to create that copy inside of GitHub and then deploy that out to Azure Static Web Apps. And finally, how we could create the database and update our application to then use that database.